Hi guys, today we're talking about an argument that first or later you will have to face: how to scale your 3D printing farm. If you have one or more printers and decide to scale to more machines, you may think that just adding another printer will do the trick. Well, ain't that easy. You see, when rigging up a 3D printing farm, you will have boundaries dictated mostly by the products you're making and your environment. If you don't want to face problems in the future, these 5 principles on how to scale your 3D printing business will help you make better decisions. I'm Richard. This is 3D Printing for Money, the channel that helps you make more money with your 3D printer. Or printers, why own only one? Bam! At a certain point, if you start getting a lot of orders and requests, you must have your farm optimized for fast scalability and bring downtime to the minimum. Believe me, it sucks to be in a situation where you have to fulfill many orders and have to deal with broken printers, issues, or worse, the wrong printer. These principles will work the best if you already have a knowledge in 3D printers and moving first steps in creating a 3D printer farm. If you already own a 3D printing farm, let me know in the comments how you manage your 3D printing farm. First principle for scaling a farm: rig a 3D printer farm with a printer model you already know. I see many people with one or two printers that get a third one and tear their hair out to figure out how to make it work properly. A good knowledge of a Cartesian printer like an Ender 3, a Prusa, CR10 automatically doesn't translate to a hassle-free experience with a Corexu printer, and vice versa. Adding a printer you're already familiar with will allow you to solve possible issues down the road. And if you really want a different printer, do extensive testing before starting to print your products. After you ironed the things you don't like and made it a reliable machine for your standards, then you can consider adding it to your farm. But my personal best advice is to have a farm of the same printer. Having the same printer will ease modding if your printers aren't stock. Remember, your objective in a 3D printing farm is to optimize 3D printing production, not to test and tear machines apart. I hardly know anyone that leaves their printer stock, but from a production standpoint, you will waste less time doing what already you know instead of guessing the results of the modifications. Even more, having one printer type will allow you to create only one G-code for every product. Slicing in C doesn't require much time, maybe a couple of minutes to figure out orientation, infills, supports, brim, other parameters, but if you have to do different G-codes for all the printers for hundreds of items, you got a time management problem. Point number 2, scale based on your current needs. Don't add a printer for the joy of having a shiny paperweight. If you owned a delivery company and bought with your money 100 delivery trucks, how would it feel to have 50 trucks collecting dust on the parking lot? Apply the same principle here. The worst thing that you can do is having a printer that stays off for weeks straight. Add a machine when you need a machine, not when you want a machine or would like a machine. As for point number 1, if you need to scale, it is because you need to print specific items. If you're printing cookie cutters, 2 smaller machines will do better than 1 huge Corexi. If you overshoot and get a printer you aren't familiar with, there's a high chance it will end collecting dust. Talking from personal experience here. Point number 3, besides printers, materials are another big factor in farm optimization. Storage is a huge thing too commonly overlooked. It doesn't matter if you're running resin or filament, you have to keep your materials dry in a warmish temperature. 99% of materials issues is related to poor storage. Trust me, show me a failed print, and if material is to blame, usually it's caused by improper storage. For filaments, humidity is the worst enemy, and all materials are affected by that. I make a huge warning on this topic in my book, 3D Printing for Money, if you want to check it out, link in description by the way. And similar precautions must be taken also for resins. Cold temperatures below 20 Celsius affect viscosity of the resin, and if not preheated once pouring in the resin tray, it underperforms, causing delamination and artifacts. I'm not personally a huge fan of preheating the resin with heat guns, hot water, or other systems before you print, because they will A, take time, and B, in the past, I saw that a high increase of temperature in a short time affects the resin and gave me very funky results. Many people developed cheap solutions to seal the material with plastic boxes, or buying fairly expensive solutions like a filament dryer like this one and this one. If from a hobbyist point of view, it may be viable, if you have 200 plus rolls of filament and 30-50 bottles of resin, you can see that cost goes off the chart. As always, the easiest solution is the cheapest. After you finish the print, grab your roll and put it back in the plastic bag it came in. Amount spent, $0. For resins, a cardboard box placed near a heat source or a wall heater is enough. If you have spare wardrobe, you can make wonders for both. In my printer farm, I have shelving with rows of printers, and on top and below, a smaller row just for materials. I optimized my workflow to eliminate packing and unpacking, and most of the time I run an entire roll straight in a couple of days, just swapping print surfaces and starting again the printer. This continuous printing decreases load and unload tasks that can drain your time very easily. Also, keep the materials near your printers, like a norm length. You don't have to go physically anywhere, just reach down or up. We talked about the hardware related optimization. Let's see how to manage a farm with remote software. Point number four, software automation. Setting up a remote controllable environment can help you shave a little time, like preheating the printers via Wi-Fi if you are elsewhere, checking out the printers with a camera, and detect issues with algorithms like Spaghetti Detective. In the future, I'll make a video on softwares for farm optimization, but for 90% of applications, the most straightforward setup is composed by a smart plug, a Raspberry Pi, a camera in the room, and a fume detector. This setup will allow you to shut on or off the printers with a smart plug with your cell phone and start printing from another room with Octoprint. The camera can give you extra feedback when needed, or assess if there's the necessity of an intervention. The fume detector is the last resort before a possible fire, but with today's print, a fire is a very remote case. But you know the drill, better safe than sorry. We will talk more about software optimization, but what is your favorite 3D printing software for controlling remotely your printers? Let me know in the comments. Point number five, maintenance, the elephant in the room. Simply said, a well-maintained printer will grant you fewer printing problems, and a well-maintained farm will grant you a workplace that requires less human intervention. As far as I see it, less time spent in the printing room, the better. I can compromise on speed, I can compromise on printing time, but I won't compromise on my personal time. Time is the most valuable resource, and from a business standpoint, I prefer to dedicate my energies to more valuable tasks than putting the repair hat on and spending hours repairing or figuring issues with the printers. I think you get it. I'm a huge fan of preventive maintenance. It is better to invest 5 minutes in a checkup than 1 hour in late maintenance. In my printer farm, I carry out maintenance based on printing time. For easing the process and to not forget what I did weeks prior, I use a maintenance plan. And this plan, from today, is freely downloadable. I'll put a link in the description. This maintenance plan can be compiled by hand or via Excel based on your personal preference. In this configuration, it holds two printers for a 750-hour span, about a month of continuous printing. And I suggest you to tag or name your printers so it's easier to remember what you did on all machines. As you can see, it has a 250-hour milestone, about 10 days, a 500-hour one, 3 weeks, and 751, about 1 month. Bear in mind that these are printing hours. If your printer for some reason stays off for an entire week, you can delay the checkup. All the milestones have a box where you can insert the date when you did the last checkup, so you will know when it was the last time you did maintenance. There is also a section for notes where I write things that I'm sure that after a month I've already forgotten. I'm a human and I forget things. So guys, these are the 5 principles to help you manage better your 3D printing farm. With these 5 tips, you can increase your productivity and waste less time down the road. How do you manage your 3D printing farm? Let me know down in the comments. If you found these principles helpful, subscribe for more content that will help you in your 3D printing journey. This is all for today. Stay sharp, stay safe, and see you in the next one.